Well, Goa Chief Minister Manohar Parrikar passing away after a prolonged illness at the age of 63. The Prime Minister, the BJP Chief Amit Shah, Defence Minister Nirmala Sitharaman, they're all heading to Goa. They're going to be part of the Chief Minister of Goa's final journey. Manohar Parrikar's mortal remains are going to be kept at the BJP office in Panaji from 9:30 a.m. to 10:30 a.m. In fact, Kamlesh Sutara, correspondent in Goa, has been telling us how the news of his death has plunged the state in an absolute sorrow. In fact, people are grieving his death. They are already arriving in large numbers, and later the body of the former defense minister and chief minister will be taken to the Kala Academy in the state capital, where people can also pay their tributes to him. Then at 4 in the evening, Manohar Parrikar's funeral procession will begin. He will be laid to rest at 5 in the evening today. The center has already announced a national mourning in wake of Mr. Manohar Parrikar's demise. Tributes, as I mentioned before, are pouring in, as he has been a very popular leader and Goa's most favorite son. Parrikar had been battling pancreatic cancer for more than a year now, but he braved all odds. He was carrying about his work normally. Manohar Parrikar had also served as the defense minister of the country in the Modi government. Kamlesh Sutar joins us for more on this. And Kamlesh, just give us a sense of, you know, the mood on the ground, because I can very well understand just how the state would be in a complete shock and sorrow. The news of his demise really evoking some very, very shocked reactions, because he was such a popular leader and someone, you know, who despite all odds persevered. It's amazing how, despite his treatment, his visits to Delhi and abroad, he continued with his normal work.
Well, indeed, and that is what made Manohar Parrikar very popular among the people of Goa, and that is why a sea of people has already started to gather at the state BJP headquarters. People are queuing up here since morning to pay their last respects. The mortal remains are expected to reach here at the state BJP headquarters at 9:30, and from 9:30 to 10:30, people can pay their respects to their beloved leader. And as you rightly mentioned, he was one of the most illustrious sons of Goa. Perhaps people have no politician from Goa till now, till date, perhaps it wouldn't be wrong to say, has received so much of love and affection.
Yes.
From the people of Goa at large for almost two decades. Manohar Parrikar has dominated the political scenes, be it as the chief minister or as the leader of opposition. He has left his marks, his footprints in every sphere of life of Goa, be it administration, be it politics, be it social, or any other aspect. Manohar Parrikar was one person who was a true Goan by heart, and was accessible to every Goaker here, as they say. Every Goan would remember him as an able administrator, as a simpleton, an austere leader who was known for his simplicity. People would see him walking on the streets alongside with them. They would see the chief minister on a scooter reaching his office. That was something which was really unheard of. You've seen the kind of airs some politicians have, but Manohar Parrikar was completely completely different from he was completely class apart from all the politicians. So it was very unheard of people to see a chief minister living such a simple life, and that is what made him unique and so much close to the hearts of people. A chief minister waiting at a roadside tea stall, sipping a cup of tea with them and discussing their problems. Generally, a chief minister is someone, you know, people would not discuss their local issues with them, be it problems of their local cleanliness or sanitation. Manohar Parrikar would not just entertain them, not just listen to their problem, but used to see to it that these problems are resolved. The administration, something which, you know, Manohar Parrikar was known for, as the kind of control that he had over administration, in spite of being a politician, leading a government known in a state which was very volatile. The political situation would turn volatile in every couple of months, but Manohar Parrikar was someone who brought almost it to a halt. He led governments that were stable. He not just only took party MLAs along, but was someone who could take the allies along. So what we are just witnessing is that the way allies are saying that we had supported Manohar Parrikar and not any party. So with Manohar Parrikar not not around, the situation is going to change. The entire dynamics are going to change. The dynamics of alliance are going to change. So if not Manohar Parrikar, somebody to take along this coalition at this point of time, we need a leader of that stature, and that is what is leading to that political problem in Goa. But apart from politicians, you know, people at, in Goa have loved him so much. They still are here. These are people, these are not party workers. They are coming here, most of them here. The sorrow, the grief on their faces here to see. They are here bidding a tearful farewell to their favorite leader. It was since yesterday when the news first came in, people had started gathering at his residence near Dona Paula in large numbers. Just
absolutely
to inquire about his health. When the first news came in that his health remains extremely critical, even then people had started gathering, and now they are here to bid him a final farewell.
Oh, that's true. And Saeed, Zafar Islam from the BJP is also with us. You know, Saeed, we're getting in these visuals of people coming out in such large numbers, and this kind of outpouring of love, tributes, condolences on social media is also testament to the love, respect and adulation that Manohar Parrikar enjoyed among the masses. You know, do you think that that's something that stood out about Manohar Parrikar, the man next door image, someone who was so easy to have a conversation with, someone who was relatable, someone, you know, who enjoyed this kind of credibility and excellent relations with all political opponents?
Well, the long queue is a testimony of his stature in the minds of the people of Goa.
Yes.
He was loved purely because of his simplicity, because he was a commoner, because he was everybody was able to approach him, he was able to meet everyone, and he was able to resolve issues of, and concern of the people of Goa. Mm-hmm. And that's across cutting party line, people were used to feel very comfortable interacting with him, engaging with him. And I have personally been in Goa many times, and I know the kind of the popularity he used to enjoy, and something which is very, very rare in any state you visit. People from different caste, creed, religion, they all used to love him purely because he was simply a commoner and a common man on the street. You will find, and you can, and even he will able to, he was able to relate with the late Mr. Parrikar. So I think the popularity, the admiration which he enjoyed is something which is there in everyone's mind. That's why I said that we are in a state of sadness today, because all of us are able to recollect our engagement, our meetings with him. And I still remember when he had invited all of us at his residence, few of us, and how humble he was. I mean, I was new to the party, and I was little hesitant in terms of visiting his place as when he was a defense minister, and I still remember how he made everyone comfortable and how he was engaging everyone. I mean, that is something only suggests that how simple he was from his heart, and even when he was approaching a small karyakarta like me. So people will always remember him very fondly, and when you talk about the replacement, and I think it is not crossing our mind, and it is not this. It is something which needs to be done, and I'm sure the Honorable Gadkari ji is already there. He's also another tall figure in Goa and Maharashtra, and everyone knows the kind of the respect he enjoys among the people of Goa and among all the political parties. I don't think that finding a replacement will be an issue, but of course nobody can fill that gap what the Honorable late Mr. Parrikar has been able to enjoy and occupy in the state of Goa.
Absolutely, indeed. Mohammed Khan, he was also the defense minister. He had a three-year-long stint as the defense minister during the Modi-led government, but unfortunately the political controversy over the controversial Rafael fighter jet deal, which has been a prominent issue with your party, had cast a shadow on his tenure. If you could just tell us a little bit more about the interaction and the meeting that the Congress president had with Mr. Manohar Parrikar, which unfortunately also became very controversial.
Yes, absolutely. One of the most interesting things that you must know about the Rafale deal and the allegations being made by the Congress party is that the one person who was never held to be complicit or having participated in the scam was Mr. Parrikar. We always pointed that fact out. We pointed out the fact that Mr. Parrikar wasn't even present there, that on the day when the Rafale deal was altered and signed in Paris, he was actually inaugurating a fisheries project here. He was not at all party to the decision, was always our case. And we argued that Mr. Parrikar was being suborned and compelled by this government to whitewash its sins, but we never accused him of being a party to the scam that was Rafale. That is a very important distinction that emerges from all our documents. The second point is that while Rahulji did meet Mr. Parrikar, he met him only for the purpose of inquiring about his health and to wish him luck. Unfortunately, the controversy you refer to arose because someone posted a clip online and seemed to suggest that Rahulji was referring to the contents of the meeting that took place. But he wasn't. He was speaking in a general tone about something else, about the INT documents and other related papers. Mr. Parrikar took it otherwise. Rahulji clarified that controversy.
Yes, why do you think that moment upset him? Because Mr. Parrikar had accused the Congress of fabricating facts. Mohammed Khan, was there then a clarification issued? Because there was that time when Mr. Parrikar was extremely upset with what had come out from that meeting. But later on, yes, please go ahead.
Absolutely. The clarification was issued almost within the next few hours of Mr. Parrikar writing to Rahulji. And Rahulji himself clarified. He didn't clarify through a spokesperson. He didn't clarify through an oblique reference. He clarified directly to Mr. Parrikar that that is not what happened. I did not talk about what you and I discussed. I was referring to past events which have been discussed over these last few months. And it was a very, very important thing. Rahulji could have ignored the issue as well, but he didn't. Out of his respect for Mr. Parrikar, he clarified that he had upheld the propriety and norms of their meeting. I think that was how two great leaders sorted out issues in a very gentlemanly fashion.
Very interesting. Saeed Zafar Islam, Pramod Sawant's name is emerging as the front runner for the chief minister's post. Would there be some objections raised by your allies, particularly the Maharashtravadi Gumantak party, because one of their own MLAs has thrown in his hat. He has proposed his name for the CM's post. Do you think that will have any issues with regards to the alliance on numbers?
Very honestly, I'm not able to navigate my mind towards finding his replacement and who will be the possible replacement.
Sure, sir, I completely understand your sentiments, and that's totally understandable given the fact that the nation is in mourning.
And our minds are not there, but let me tell you, since your reporter has shared this name, I don't follow me.
Yes.
She may have had this information from someone. But I have absolutely no clue who will be the possible replacement and who are the possible options, first of all, and who emerges as the winner. Something which only the leadership will decide, and only the leadership can comment at this point. But all I can say that our senior leaders are there, and they are the best person to engage with everyone, understand the dynamics, understand the concern expressed by the alliance partner, and understand the reservation, if any of our elected leader has all these things. They are is very easy to resolve, because once you have a senior leader of his stature, of Mr. Nitin Gadkari, then these issues are not an important issue, because these issues are something which can be addressed very comfortably by the Honorable Minister, Mr. Nitin Gadkari. So I'm not overly concerned or worried, or for that matter, that we need to really get worried about finding a replacement, because something which has to be done, which will be done, and which will be done amicably, comfortably, without having any resistance from anyone, and something which the party leadership decides is something which is being accepted by every single the elected members of Bharatiya Janata Party. As far as alliance is concerned, they all know Nitin Gadkari ji. Even last time when he went there, he was the one who engaged them. He was the one who spoken to them. So they will be easily able to discuss with him. And if there is anything which they need to discuss, they will be able to discuss it. But I'm not overly concerned about finding a replacement. That's something has to happen. It will happen.
So does that remain a concern for the Congress party? Mohammad Khan, just my last question, your thoughts on the names that are coming up for the chief minister, Pramod Sawant emerging as the front runner, the Congress also now staking claim to form the next government. There are going to be some very important by-elections that has to happen as well. Your last thoughts as I wrap up this discussion.
Both the Congress and the BJP are far short of the 21 mark. The BJP is at 12, the Congress is at 14. There have been defections in both parties, and I think the mathematics of it will dictate that there is an election. I wish you had an MGP spokesperson on the panel, because they're going to be crucial in deciding whether the government is going to be formed or whether there's a fresh election. I personally believe that to respect the wishes of the Goa people, we must go for an election.
All right, I'm going to leave it at that. Mohammad Khan, Saeed Zafar Islam, thank you both for joining us and speaking at a time when the entire nation and the state of Goa is in mourning. We do appreciate your time, your remarks and thoughts. Thanks once again, Kamlesh. I'm going to thank you for now, but we're slipping into a short break. I'm going to keep coming back to you, get a sense of all that's happening in the state of Goa, with the Prime Minister already planning to head to the state along with the BJP President and the Defence Minister.
Thanks for watching the video. For more such news and updates, please like, share and subscribe to India Today. Also check out our other great videos from our channel. We know you will love to.